Good morning. Oh, actually, no, it's good afternoon now. Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to enjoy your fishing. First of all, just like to say thanks for watching the videos. Thanks for subscribing. Really means a lot, guys. I've come down to Hartsholme Park just to fish two feeder lines, really. One short, just to fish for anything, and one longer to see if I can snare a couple of the better bream in here. Right, I've been asked just to show where I decide to fish on the feeder. So I'll run you through that when I start. I know they've been catching one or two fish on the waggler, so I'm and they mainly fished that at about 18 to 20 meters. So I'm going to do a line there. So that's how I decide that. I just want to find a bit of a clear bottom, right? And I'll do that by just putting a bomb on. And then what I'll do is my long line, I'll probably do that about for, excuse me. I'll probably do that at about 35, 36 meters. And then if I don't get anything, I can just push out a bit then. Same again, I'll use a bomb just to try and find a clear spot. Really easy conventional baits I'm using today. Ground bait I'm using, this combination of the skimmer and bream and the rosin supreme, both the dark ground baits from Revolution Baits. If you can see that bait, so we've got nice simple, got some dead reds and pinkies, casters and some live reds. I've also got some red worms and a match pack of dendrobinas if I decide I want to put a bit of worm in, but I won't start with. Right, so let's have a look. And all my hook lengths are fluorocarbon. Right, I'm going to start on my short line, guys. Unfortunately, the wind's dropped. Hopefully it'll come back. But what I've done, how I've decided on my lines, is I found a clear spot out there at 36 metres. So I've decided that's on my long line. How I found that was that obviously I've put a bomb on and I can feel that it's clear, it's not pulling in any silt or anything like that. And the same on this line. This line is just under 20 meters, and that's what most people fish the waggler line on, right? So I'll just see if there's any small fish there. That's my first cast. Both rigs are free running rigs. What I've done on my long line is put five of those in with the ground bait. And, excuse me, we're just a few pinkies, few dead reds, and a few casters. Not much loose feed, but obviously, and what I'll do is I'll give that a try after about 40 minutes, so just see if it settles over it. Right, now what I'm going to do on this is I'm just going to keep casting this. In the same spot. There we go. Might take a little bit for the fish to come on. We're going to change to that feeder. A little tiny feeder. Just don't feel right as it's sitting in the water that way. Be interesting to see if we do get out. Soon as the wind stops, it's like covered in scum. Only just started, so I'll let you know how I'm getting on in an hour, guys. All right. I've had a bite on my short line. Been fishing for 50 minutes, and then I've had two perch in two puts in on my longer line. Oh, that's all right, we've got a bream. Lovely fish. Fishing on two reds, tip with a pinky. Next 50 minutes has been quiet. I've had a little roach. And a perch about 8 ounce. So it's hard going, guys. Started introducing a bit of worm. That's a good eel. That is a big eel. Here we go, look. That's the only trouble when you start introducing a bit of worm. Right. I thought it was a big bream for a minute. Try it short a minute. That eel must have been at least 2 pound. Well guys, my battery had run out, but I thought I'll have one more cast and I've caught a carp. That's unbelievable, that. So yeah, I caught a carp short at 20 metres. I'm going to call that me last fish, because it's not been good, to be honest. It hasn't, but I've never had a carp out of Hartsholme before. I haven't. So the way the bite was, like, to be honest, I thought it was an eel, but because they normally take your tip right round, but I'm gonna book it. Oh, that's made me day, that has. So I'll get packed up and then I'll show you what I've caught. All right, it's not a lot. I mean, I've had a bream, but three and a half pound, then an eel that's a good 2 pound, and then that carp. So lovely, just on sort of bream gear, so well happy with that. Anyway, I'll talk to you in a bit when I get packed up, guys. Right, let's get these out for you. Got my mat there, so we don't hurt them. Oh, and he's gone. There's the eagle. Come on, fella. Come on. Get out. Here we go. There we go, here's the lovely carp. Here we go. There you go. Lovely fish. Pop in back. And then we got put one. And we've got a couple of oats and three perch. So So that wasn't bad anyway. That carp about £4 and that bream about three and a half pound. That was a really good eel, right? So not too bad. That water is so cold today. So temperature's really dropped at night though now, hasn't it? So like 2 weeks ago you'd be able to stand in this without any waders out on, like it was that warm, because it's only a shallow lake even though it's big. Right, but so yeah, gotta be happy with that on a tough day. Right, you know, I'm sure I'd have caught, if I'd brought a waggler down as well, I'm sure I would have caught a few small fish, but then I wouldn't have got that bream in that carp. I mean, that's the first carp I've ever had out of here. You know, the only, like, it's not commercial, like, there's not many carp in it at all, so I'm delighted to have had that out of here. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for subscribing. As I say, you know, because somebody asked me, one of the subscribers asked me, you know, how do you decide how far out you're going to fish with a feeder? Well, you know, I know my short line, I know the lads have been coming down and fishing the waggler, so I'd been fishing between 20 and 18 metres, so that was a guide for my first line. And so what I've done is put a bomb on and just found a clear spot, and I've fished there on my short line. I have. And then my longer line, if you look, that island, that island is about 50 metres. So what I've done is I've started at 36, and then it gives you somewhere to go. Then I found a clear spot which was at 36, and then if I need to, I can unclip and go another 2 metres and keep doing that, like. But even that hasn't worked today. I've only had the eel, the big eel, and the bream out there. I've had everything else on the short line, but I've only had half a dozen small fish, like. So but that's how it is. Anyway, as I said, thanks for watching, thanks for subscribing, guys. There's lots to come on the channel. I've got quite a few golden rod qualifiers. We'll soon have the Allcroft teams of four. Right, we're putting two teams in that. We fished that last year. We had two teams in it last year, and you're fishing against the, in that league, you're fishing against the some of the best anglers in the country. You know, lots of England internationals in that. So I'll get that on. I'll get them on film for you as well. And anyway, thanks for watching, thanks for subscribing, really means a lot, guys. If you haven't subscribed, please consider subscribing. And as always, take care, look after yourselves, and enjoy your fishing. Bye for now, guys.